Could you imagine life on a planet so hot that the atmosphere evaporates away into space? So hot that even the strongest metals would not just melt, but boil. You are watching Matter. In this video, you will learn about the planet that is hotter than most stars in the galaxy. The star Kelt 9 is located about 670 light-years from Earth. It is classified as an A-type blue giant star. A-type stars are some of the largest and hottest stars in the universe. Kelt 9 is at least twice as large as the Sun and nearly twice as hot. Hot giant stars like this tend to burn through all of their hydrogen fuel very quickly, and so they don't live for very long, at least on astronomical timescales. Stars like Kelt 9 typically only shine for less than a billion years. Compare that to our Sun, which is expected to live at least 10 times as long. Because A-type stars are so short-lived, they are also relatively rare, compromising only 0.6% of all the stars in the Milky Way. But age and size are far from being the strangest things about the star. The strangest thing is the planet that orbits around it. Extrasolar planets, planets in orbit around stars other than our Sun, are not themselves unusual. To date, astronomers have been able to confirm nearly 5,000 such exoplanets, but the fact that an exoplanet has been detected around a star as big and as hot as Kelt 9 is unexpected. Giant stars like this burn so hot and so quickly that they create an environment that is hostile to planetary formation, and yet one planet, Kelt 9b, has been found in orbit around the star. Kelt 9b is a gas giant planet, much like Jupiter, except that it is 2.8 times as massive. Jupiter orbits the Sun at an average distance of 484 million miles, which is a little more than 5 times further than the Earth. It takes 12 years for Jupiter to complete one orbit. On the other hand, the closest planet to the Sun in our solar system is Mercury, circling the Sun once every 88 days in its 29 million mile wide orbit. Kelt 9b, despite being larger than Jupiter, orbits its star far closer than Mercury, 11 times closer. The planet's orbit has a radius of only 3 million miles, but because the star itself has a radius of more than 1 million miles, Kelt 9b circles a mere 2 million miles above the surface of its star. At that distance, it is able to complete a full orbit in less than 1.5 days. If an astronaut could visit this planet, they would see a blinding orb of light 70 times larger than the Sun appears in our sky. But this gargantuan Sun would not rise nor set. Kelt 9b is so close to its parent star that it has become tidally locked. Tidal forces acting between the planet and the star are so great that the planet's orbit and rotation have become synchronized, forcing one hemisphere of the planet to constantly face the star. This is the case with the Earth's moon, and why we can only ever see one side of it, because Kelt 9b is tidally locked within its star. One side of the planet is trapped in constant blinding daylight, while the other side is trapped in eternal night. Bathed in never-ending sunlight from the nearby star, temperatures on the daylight hemisphere skyrocket to an unthinkable 7,800 degrees Fahrenheit, making it hotter than more than 75% of actual stars in our galaxy. The temperatures on Kelt 9a are well above the melting point of any known material. Traces of iron and titanium vapors have been detected in the atmosphere of Kelt 9b. At these temperatures, the molecular bonds between atoms are torn apart. It is so hot that the entire planet would glow a dull red, like a burning ember in space. Remarkably, Kelt 9b's extreme temperature is only one of this planet's bizarre attributes. The planet orbits very close to its star, close enough to become tidally locked, as we mentioned, but any closer and the planet would pass the star's so-called Roche Limit, beyond which the tidal forces are so great that the planet would be torn apart. Because Kelt 9b is just outside this Roche Limit, and just because it's being constantly bombarded by its intense solar radiation, the planetary atmosphere is being blasted away at an incredible rate. As many as 12 million metric tons of material are blown off the planet into space by the solar wind every second. Every 10 million years, it will lose an entire Earth's worth of mass. Kelt 9b might almost resemble an ultra-massive comet, with a bright tail of gas stretching out behind it for millions of miles. In a few billion years, the planet might even evolve into something different. It is theorized that the gaseous atmosphere will someday be lost entirely, leaving behind only the dense, naked core. Members of this theoretical class of planet are called Chythonian planets. As of yet, there is only one probable candidate with this new classification, the recently discovered TOI-849b. This planet is roughly Neptune-sized, nearly 3.5 Earths across. However, its mass is 40 times that of Earth, suggesting a density much higher than a typical gas giant. The probable explanation is that TOI-849b is an abnormally large rocky planet. This would be the most massive rocky planet ever discovered. Such a large object would have a very strong gravitational pull. Astronomers would expect it to begin gathering a thick, gaseous atmosphere eventually growing to the size of a gas giant planet. The theory is that TOI-849b was indeed a gas giant planet at some time in its past, but that its atmosphere has been completely torn away by solar radiation. All that remains is the dense exposed core. TOI-849b's host star is also relatively old and evolved, lending even more credence to the theory. Yet another peculiarity regarding planet KELT-9b is its orbit, but KELT-9b's orbit is inclined by a staggering 86.7 degrees, nearly perpendicular. Planetary systems are believed to form out of a proto-planetary disk, a disk of leftover gas and dust that orbits around a newborn star. The dust eventually collapses down to form planets, moons, asteroids, and everything else. The principle of conservation of angular momentum would dictate that the rotation of both the disk and the star should be roughly aligned. That is why all the planets in the solar system lie roughly along the same plane. The fact that KELT-9b is in a polar orbit around its star seems, at first, to defy the laws of physics. Astronomers can't say for sure exactly how this planet's orbit came to be so extremely inclined. It's possible that something came along to perturb the protoplanetary disk during formation. Either that, or something knocked the star on its side, making the star the one that is misaligned, not the planet. Another theory involves tidal interactions and orbital resonances, causing angular momentum to be exchanged between the two bodies and slowly ramping up the inclination of the planet's orbit. How KELT-9b got to be in an orbit so close to its parent star at all is also somewhat of a mystery. Although it is one of the very hottest known exoplanets, KELT-9b is perhaps surprisingly not alone. It belongs to a class of exoplanet known as hot Jupiters, gas giant planets with very short orbital periods. Astronomers have already found a few hundred such hot Jupiters. This is actually completely expected, given the methods we use to find new exosolar planets. One method is to watch the star's position. A planet's gravity will tug slightly on the star, causing it to wobble back and forth. The bigger the planet, the bigger the wobble, and therefore the easier it is to detect. We can also watch for a temporary dip in the star's brightness, caused by a planet passing in front of the star during the planet's orbit. So, our exoplanet detection methods are biased towards finding hot Jupiters, large planets that orbit very close to their host stars. Still, that doesn't resolve the question of why they exist there in the first place. Astronomers still aren't quite sure. According to our current understanding of planetary formation, the regions closer to the stars are far too hot for volatile, lightweight elements, like hydrogen and helium, to condense. Gas giant planets are made primarily out of these lightweight gases, and so it should be impossible for them to form close to their stars. There are two prevailing theories. The first is that they formed exactly where their present orbits are. This would be unexpected, but it may be possible for a rocky core a few times the mass of the Earth to form close to the star. Its gravity may then be strong enough to hold to a tenuous gaseous envelope for long enough for it to eventually evolve into a fully gas giant. The second, more likely theory is planetary migration. We tend to think of planets as being fixed in their immovable orbits, like trains on an unchanging track. But that isn't necessarily true. Gravitational perturbations and interaction between planets can cause the orbits of the planets to change. Sometimes, very drastically. Our solar system has been around for 4.5 billion years, so the planets have all had a chance to find steady, stable orbits. But that wasn't always the case. Billions of years ago, the solar system would have been a much more chaotic place. The constant gravitational tug-of-war between the newly forming planets caused orbits to shift and change constantly, migrating inwards or outwards, seeking a more stable position. This mechanism is the most probable culprit for creating hot Jupiters. A gas giant planet forms far away from the parent star, gravitational and tidal forces then push the planet inward until it stabilizes in a narrow, short-period orbit close around the star. The ultra-hot gas giant planet KELT-9b is one of the strangest, most extreme worlds that we've ever discovered. Further studies and new advances in technology, like the soon-to-be-launched James Webb Space Telescope, might tell us what else KELT-9b is hiding within its hellish cloudscapes. Thank you for watching Matter. Make sure you like this video and subscribe to the channel to discover more about strange alien worlds like this one.